Hi, I'm Michelle, and an Idahoan that has a love for the great outdoor opportunities that exist in our state. Recently, I've learned that something different is happening here in the Payette National Forest. For the past 5 years, the forest has been a part of the Collaborative Forest Landscape Restoration Program, and forest restoration work is in full swing within these ecosystems. An important part of this program is the collaborative process that the Payette Forest Coalition is a key player in. The Payette Forest Coalition is an independent group of interested members of the public that represent all interest in land stewardship. For these projects, the Payette National Forest and Payette Forest Coalition came together to increase the scale and pace of forest restoration projects, improve communication and trust, and understand values and needs of various interest groups. These projects that bring the interest of all parties to the table have promoted economic growth and improved forest and watershed health. They have enhanced fish and wildlife habitat through vegetation thinning, road improvements, riparian enhancements, invasive species management, and fuels treatment. Much of the Payette National Forest is within a fire-adapted ecosystem, meaning historically, frequent lower-intensity fires reduce fuel that created natural diversity, such as forest openings, meadows, and desirable animal habitat. As a part of their collaborative goals, projects have been developed that generate increased timber value and much-needed good restoration work. The Evergreen Sawmill near New Meadows has added a second shift due largely to the Lost Creek, Boulder Creek project and frequently posts a help wanted sign. These projects have also helped fill log yards from Meridian to Grangeville.
It's allowed us to increase shifts. It's given me the more of the confidence that we can hire more people on, that we can grow the company. And I hope they keep just doing these projects, because every time you see these projects, it's a win-win for everybody.
The win-win comes by thinning the overgrown forest and by providing economic stability to these mountain towns. The effort also focuses on road management and recreational opportunities, and those two can present a challenging debate. But bringing people together to talk about these issues produces an outcome that reaps strong benefits.
In a lot of places, there's roads are redundant also. So they'll get a road out of the stream bottom and leave a road on a ridge top or a mid-slope, still keep access.
The Lost Creek Watershed and Lost Valley Reservoir are very popular recreational areas. Recreation improvements were needed, and the collaborative effort brought people together to make improvements.
It was very important to include in that project some work to improve those dispersed campsites. And now it is going to be a much more pleasant place for people to go and camp and take their families and their kids and go fishing.
The bottom line is that collaboration works. Already these accomplishments include 84,000 acres of fuel treatment, 132 miles of stream restoration, 90,000 acres of wildlife habitat enhancement, 16 stream crossings improved for aquatic organism passage, nearly 150,000 CCF of timber sold, enhanced and upgraded recreational opportunities, and 10,000 acres of noxious weed treatment. All of us value our public lands and want to see these incredible forested ecosystems survive for generations to come. Forest restoration has started in these special places like the Payette National Forest, and the collaborative process is key to implementing positive results in the landscape. Collaboration brings our values together, and together more and more forested lands are being proactively brought back into healthy conditions. If you're an interested Idahoan like me, learn more about the collaborative process and then pull up a chair to the table so that these significant accomplishments through collaboration can continue into the future.